Good morning students, back to chemistry in everyday life. I am just giving a small recap of what we have studied in the previous videos. Drug. What is a drug? Drug is a low molecular weight chemical substance. When the drug produces a useful effect, then the drug is called as medicine. Use of medicine for therapeutic effect is called as chemotherapy. What is the classification of drug? Drugs are classified into four types based on the pharmacological action, based on the drug action, based on the molecular structure, based on the molecular target. These are the four classification of the drugs. What is the last part of the classification? It is nothing but molecular drug. My drug is going to interact with the molecular target like carbohydrates, proteins, nucleic acids, and it is going to produce a response. So my proteins are going to act like an enzyme. Means the enzyme part of the protein is going to act like a catalyst. In what way an enzyme can act like a catalyst? First way, the enzyme will be providing a site for the substrate. That site is called as active site. So now chemical reaction proceeds. Second way, my enzyme is going to provide a functional group for the substrate. So chemical reaction proceeds. That will be attacked by the reagent. So chemical reaction proceeds. Now my drugs are going to act like enzyme inhibitors. How a drug is going to inhibit the enzyme? By two ways. First way, my drug is going to compete with the enzyme for a chemical reaction to occur. So those drugs are called as my drug is going to compete with the substrate for the active site of the enzyme. So I am going to call my drug as competitive inhibitors. In this case, instead of substrate, my drug will go and bind to the enzyme, so no chemical reaction proceeds. Second way, my drug is going to bind with the enzyme in a site other than the active site. What is that site called as? That site is called as allosteric site. So in that case, the structure of the enzyme is modified. My substrate cannot recognize it, so no chemical reaction proceeds. So these are the two ways by which your drug is going to exhibit an inhibitory action on the enzymes. Next, we saw about receptors. You know what are receptors? They are mainly important for communication process. They are located in the cell membrane, projected to the exterior. So when my receptor is mimicking, when my drug is mimicking the messenger, I am going to call that as agonist. When my drug is going to go against the messenger, I am going to call that as an antagonist. Then we saw about two therapeutically important drugs. We saw about antacids. Then we saw about antihistamines. Under antacids, we were seeing about cimetidine. And under antihistamines, we were seeing about bromofenirmin and terpidine, etc. Antihistamines will go and bind to the receptors of the histamine, blocking the action of histamine, because histamine is going to produce allergic reaction. We want to get rid of histamine, so we are adding antihistamines. Then we saw about neurologically active drugs. Under neurologically active drugs, we were seeing about tranquilizers and we were seeing about antidepressant drugs. We know when depression is caused. Depression is caused when noradrenaline level is less. So we need to maintain the level of noradrenaline. For that, a number of antihistamine drugs are prescribed. Then what are analgesics? Analgesics are going to relieve your pain without interfering with the central nervous system. Under analgesics, we saw about non-narcotics and narcotics. Non-narcotics, they are non-addictive. In that, we saw about paracetamol, crocin, and aspirin, which are used in the treatment of heart diseases, because they are going to dissolve even the blood clot. Then under narcotic drugs, we were seeing about morphine and its homologs, and then we saw about opium, we saw about barbiturates, okay. Then we are coming to the topic, antimicrobials. As humans, we are continuously encountered with microbes like bacteria, fungi, virus and parasites. So agents which are produced against bacteria are called as antibacterial agents. Agents which are produced against virus, antiviral, antifungal and antiparasitic. So here we are going to give more importance to antibiotics. So previously the definition given to antibiotics was, antibiotics are nothing but substances produced from one microorganisms or used to kill the other microorganism or used to inhibit the growth of other microorganisms. They are called as antibiotics. But soon instead of producing from one bacteria, it is synthetically produced. So now the definition is replaced by substances which are produced completely, that is wholly or partially by chemical synthesis, are called as antibiotics. So antibiotics are chemical substances which are produced completely or partially by chemical synthesis, such that it is used to inhibit the growth of other microbes or used to kill the growth of other microbes. It is nothing that I am removing the venoms of snake and I am taking it. Means I am taking a microorganism's product. I am going to take a microorganism's product such that microorganism's poisonous part will be removed. This is going to help my body against another microorganisms. So this is the concept. So here, why we are using a microbe's product? Because it is less toxic to the human beings, but it is more effective against other microbes. This is the reason why antibiotics are used against bacterial infections. It is like I am removing the poisonous product and I am using it in such a way such that it is effective against other microbes. See, antibiotics are very effective when administered in very low concentration, because they are going to kill the growth, they are going to kill the other microbes, or they are going to inhibit the growth of other microbes. How? They will be interfering with the metabolic activity of other microbes. This is how your antibiotics act. Now, the scientist Paul Ehrlich was awarded Nobel Prize for his discovery of a chemical substance against the disease syphilis. Now, syphilis is a bacterial infection which is going to spread from one person to other person by means of sexual contact. Now, what the scientist Paul Ehrlich did, he produced a structure which is based on arsenic. Okay? And you know, he named them as arsphenamine. He named those compounds, that arsenic based structural compounds, as arsphenamine. You know, under what name arsphenamine is marketed in the pharmacological industry? It is marketed in the name salvarsan. It is marketed in the name salvarsan. Salvarsan is an antibiotic which is used against the treatment of syphilis. Paul Ehrlich didn't stop his discovery with arsenic based structure, provided he started searching similar structures, and he found that azo dyes are also having a property to bind with the selective bacteria and inhibiting the growth of bacteria, or they are killing the bacteria. So what similarity he found between azo dyes and salvarsan? In azo dyes you have nitrogen linkages, provided in salvarsan we have arsenic linkages. After discovering azo dyes, he still started searching some more compounds which are similar to azo dyes. He found a substance, prontosil, because prontosil is also chemically similar to salvarsan, because it is also having arsenic linkages. When a person is administered with prontosil antibiotic or antibacterial agent, this prontosil will be converted to a chemically active compound called sulfanilamide. Okay, prontosil is the first antibiotic agent whose structure is similar to salvarsan. When a person is going to take prontosil, prontosil will be converted to a chemically active compound called sulfanilamide. Thus comes the discovery of sulfa drugs. So we have seen a little bit about antibacterial agents, which are otherwise called as antibiotics. Formally, antibiotics are chemical substances produced from one microbe used to kill or inhibit other microbes. But later, instead of taking a chemical compound from a microbe which is little pathogenic, scientists started producing that chemical substance synthetically or by means of chemical synthesis. So now, what is the definition of antibiotic? Antibiotic is a chemical substance which is produced completely or partially by means of chemical synthesis, is used to inhibit the growth of other microbes or used to kill other microbes. So, the second scientist came, he is Alexander Fleming. Alexander Fleming discovered the antibacterial property which is present in the fungi Penicillium. Okay, he isolated the antibacterial activity from penicillin. See, based on the action, antibiotics are classified into three categories: broad spectrum antibiotic, narrow spectrum antibiotic, limited spectrum antibiotic. The name itself is giving us a clear-cut idea. Say, for example, I have a broad spectrum antibiotic. As the name indicates, this broad spectrum antibiotic is effective for treating broad range of gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria. See, you know, a gram-positive bacteria and a gram-negative bacteria can be differentiated on the basis of gram staining, which you might have seen in biology. You might have aware of it in biology chapters. So what is broad spectrum antibiotic? When you administer a broad spectrum antibiotic, it is going to give me protection against a wide range of gram positive bacteria and gram negative bacteria. What is the example for a broad spectrum antibiotic? It will be amoxicillin or ampicillin. They are broad spectrum antibiotics. What is narrow spectrum antibiotic? Narrow spectrum antibiotic is going to provide me protection against either gram-positive bacteria or gram-negative bacteria. Not together, it will be giving protection against either gram-positive nor gram-negative bacteria. Example for narrow spectrum antibiotic will be penicillin G. Okay. Now, what is limited spectrum antibiotic? The name itself is telling me this type of antibiotic is going to offer protection against a particular disease or against a particular microbe. This is called as limited spectrum antibiotic. Now, what is chloramphenicol? Chloramphenicol is nothing but an antibiotic. This antibiotic is going to be administered orally because this can be ingested or digested well. It can reach the gut without any problem. So, chloramphenicol is a broad spectrum antibiotic which is administered orally to a patient who is suffering from cholera, typhoid, dysentery, meningitis, etc. So this is about chloramphenicol. So I have told you about antibiotics. I just want to give the action of antibiotic against today's hot topic, corona. You know, COVID-19 or coronavirus, we have seen a lot and lot information about that. See, I'm a human, right? If any foreign substance enters a human body, say it a bacteria or virus or a parasite or a fungi, who is the defense mechanism of the human body? Human's defense is two types. One is B lymphocyte, the other is T lymphocytes. B lymphocytes produce antibodies against a particular disease. T lymphocytes produces killer lymphocytes. Say, for example, this is my house. A thief has entered my house. Now, who will catch the thief first? My dog. Okay? My pet dog is going to catch the thief first. By barking, it is going to alert the people in the house. Then people in the house will come and catch hold of the thief. They will be handing over the thief to the police officer. The same way, when a bacteria, virus or fungi enters the human body, B lymphocytes, they are nothing but dogs, they will be producing antibodies. These antibodies will go and surround your bacteria or virus. Now the second police officer, that is the T lymphocytes, will come into play. T lymphocytes will produce killer cells. All the killer cells will be marching to the site where your antibodies have locked my virus or bacteria. What is the action of killer cells? The killer cells will kill the foreign substance. Now, this full place is loaded with garbage of dead cells. If I am going to leave the dead cells like that, what happens? Infection. So who will infect now? Bacterial infection happens there. See, if bacterial infection happens, who will come for remedy? My antibiotics will come for remedy because you know they will be giving macrophages. My T lymphocyte will finally give me macrophages. The macrophages will clear the garbage. This is how our human body is protecting against all the pathogens. So step one, a foreigner enters. What is step two? My B lymphocytes will produce antibodies against that foreign substance. Then T lymphocyte will send the killer cells. All the foreign cells are killed. Foreign particles are killed. Then macrophages will come and clear the system. What happens in corona? See, the virus enters. You know, it is a novel coronavirus. It is a new virus. So, my body's immune system cannot recognize whether he is my friend or he is my enemy. My body will stand and think he is a foreigner or he is my own body cells. By this time, you know, virus enters the human body and starts multiplying. It takes the control of the house. It takes the control of the human body. It stops all the other activities of the human body. And, you know, it directs the cell to do my work. You know, the virus is going to direct the cell to do its work. What is its work? To go on multiplying. When each cell has got 100 to 1000 number of virus particles, which is the target of coronavirus? The target of coronavirus is nothing but our respiratory tract. All the viral multiplied, the multiplied viral cells will go to the respiratory tract. We know about the structure of respiratory tract, especially our lungs. We have bronchi, bronchioles, air sacs. All the multiplied cells will start accumulating phlegm in the bronchi, bronchioles and air sacs. You know what is the role of the lungs? You know, it is going to purify the circulated blood, going to supply oxygen to all the parts of the body through blood and remove carbon dioxide. Correct? Now what happens, since the entire bronchi is filled with phlegm, the person is unable to breathe. Breathing difficulty. So the first aid given to the corona affected patient will be ventilator. With the support of the ventilator, the doctor is helping the patient to breathe properly. Then, now what happens once the virus has multiplied a lot? Who will come for rescue? Your T cells should send killer cells and macrophages should clear the system. This won't happen properly when each cell is rich in dead cells. You know, that will be resulting in shock, septic shock, leading to person's death. So only two treatments are possible. One, aiding the patient for breathing, that is your ventilators. Next, secondary bacterial infection occurs that can be counteracted by administering antibiotic. So it depends on the balance between your viral army and my immune system army. When viral army is dominating, it results in death. When my immune system army is dominating, the person is able to survive. Done? So I have related about antiviral and I have related about antibiotic to this. So hope you understood about antibiotics very clearly. Yes?